our today's part is about pointing theorem, and actually it is a theorem for power flow of electromagnetic wave. That means if there is a power flow, obviously there must be power in every sector. If there is any energy transfer, that means there is some power flow. And now if there is any power flow in our electromagnetic wave, it can be described by using pointing theorem. Okay, at first I will write about the theorem, then I will derive an equation for pointing theorem.
بس الميكروفون كحل صح
Yes. Any problem?
Yeah. No problem, sir. It's okay.
স্যার ফুল পেজটা আসতেছে না, লাস্ট লাস্টের টুকু আসতেছে না স্যার।
হ্যাঁ যাও। Okay, this is our pointing theorem. Pointing theorem states that the net power flowing out of a given volume V is equal to the time rate of decrease in the energy stored within V, that means within the volume, minus the conduction losses. This is the actually power flow theorem. Our pointing theorem is actually a power flow theorem which can describe the power flow of electromagnetic wave. Okay, now let us derive equation which describes our pointing theorem. Pointing vector, actually pointing theorem mathematically it can be described mathematically pointing vector P is equal to electric field vector mathematically describes this vector like this. P is equal to E cross H. This is the pointing vector. Now we have to determine the value of this E cross H. That's our target. Let us point or solving this, we have to recall our two equation. We know del cross E, our Maxwell's equation. I will consider two of our Maxwell's equation. First one, del cross E is equal to minus mu del S by del T. And this is the equation number one. Again, del cross E is equal to sigma E plus epsilon del E by del T. This is two of our Maxwell's equation. I will consider two of these, then I will write the equation for pointing theorem. Okay, now try. So our pointing vector is here. Okay, there is a vector formula like this. If we consider the divergence of two cross product vector, we can write the E is our first vector and H is our second vector. And if we take divergence of this cross product vector, there is a vector formula or vector identity, we have to write dot, that means divergence del cross E, or that means first vector minus first vector dot del cross S. This is a vector formula. It's like as if, say, applying vector identity. Actually, applying vector identity like this. If we have two vector del dot A cross B, there is A and B two vector like this. First of all, we have to write B into del cross A, that means first vector minus A dot del cross B. There is a vector formula. I have applied this formula into this equation, that means equation number three. Now I will put the value for del cross E and del cross S from equation 1 and 2 into equation 3. That means I can write. Actually, this equation is very complex and it is described in your book. You can see in your book, it is very complex mathematics. And today I have tried my best to make it simple as I can do. Let us try for simplest purpose. You can see in your book, Sadhguru book, there is quite complex. They have derived this equation quite complexly. And I have found a new formula. I think you can apply this. This can be acceptable. Putting values from equation 1 and 2 into equation 3. We get what will be the value? The first one, del dot E cross S E cross A is equal to, that means A is dot del cross E. A is means first one, A is. Then instead of del cross E, we have to put the value of del cross E, which is minus mu del S by del T. Minus mu del S by del T. Again, our second term minus, I have just applied the values from 1 and 2 in equation 3. That's the principle. Minus E, and we have to put the value of del cross H. What is the value for del cross H? Sigma E plus epsilon del E by del T. I just put the value del E plus epsilon del E by del T. That's the value. Now I have to multiply the whole term in the right side. In the left side, it is same del dot E cross H is equal to minus mu. Mu is a constant. And can anyone say what is mu? What is the name of mu? In our last class, we have described it. Can anyone say this? There is no one.
Epsilon.
What is the name of mu?
The permeability of material.
Permeability, good. Mu means permeability of material. And what is the name of sigma? What is this?
The conductivity of material.
Conductivity of the material, right. And what is epsilon?
The permittivity of material.
Permittivity of the material, good. So I think you just tried to study, good. Epsilon E del E by del T. So that's the multiplication. And we can write this equation as equation number 4. Okay, that's our equation. Del dot E cross H is equal to minus mu H del H by del T minus sigma E square minus epsilon E into del E by del T. I have to simplify these two terms. Okay, let us try. For simplification, this is our page number 1. And I now page number 2. As it is page number 2, at first I will write our previous equation, that means equation number 4 again. Del dot E cross H is equal to minus mu A del A by del T minus sigma E square minus epsilon E del E by del T. That was our equation 4. That means in our previous case. Now, I have to simplify these two terms. And for simplification, I will apply some tricks. For simplification, simplification, if I write for simplification minus mu A del A by del T is nearly equal to, I can write, minus mu into half del A square by del T. If both are same in left and right, can anyone explain if it is same or not? I have written here two format. Minus mu A del S by del T is equivalent to minus mu into half del S square by del T. If both are same ordinate.
There won't depart by two words from.
Okay, I will make it simple for you. Okay, for rough, there is a rough. This is not needed for your exam rough test or for simplification. If I just take derivative of del by del t into x square, what will be the derivative of this? What will be the derivative of x square? Like this, 2x into del x by del t. Is it right or wrong? You understand or do you can hear me?
Yes, sir. We can hear you.
If it is same del by del t of x square, that means derivative of x square is 2x del x by del t. Is it right?
Yes, sir.
If it is right, then if I just write like this, if I just shift the two into like this, half del x square by del t is equal to x into del x by del t. I have just shifted the two term, two in the left side. That means it is multiplied, and in the left side it will be divided. If it is same, left and right, I have just shifted only two. If it is same, then we can compare with our this equation. Mu, mu. It is just constant. Minus, minus, constant. Now, h means here x. Del h means del x by del t. In the right side, I can write half del x square by del t. Del x square by del t. Now, it is same or not? Understand what I want to say?
Yes, sir. Understand. We can change the value.
Yes. Yes. That means we can write instead of mu a is half of del a square by del t. Similarly, we can write for similarly. Similarly, we can write for minus epsilon e same del e by del t. What should I will write? You have to say this. What should I will write here? Ask like as our previous one.
And this epsilon.
What say? What? Yes. What will write? What? What I will write?
Minus epsilon.
Minus epsilon.
1 divided by 2.
1 divided by 2.
Delta.
Delta.
Delta E.
Delta
E.
E.
Divided by delta T.
Delta E is square. Not only E. There will be a square.
Square.
By delta
E. Yes.
Yes. Yes. So we can write like this. Okay. Now, we have to put these values on equation 4. These values on equation 4. On equation 4, we can get del dot E cross H is equal to, what should I will write? Minus mu into half del a square by del t minus sigma a square minus epsilon into half del e square by del t. Or simply we can write, that simply this del dot e cross h is equal to if I just make common of half and minus half, that means mu into del h square by del t plus epsilon del A square by del T minus sigma A square. I have just made it in simple form, just rearranged it. Okay. So what is the pointing vector? Pointing vector P is equal to E cross H. So we can write instead of E cross H, what is our pointing vector? This is our pointing vector. Pointing vector P is equal to E cross H. So we can write here del dot, we can write here del dot P, del dot P, P vector is equal to minus half mu, half mu del H square divided by del T plus epsilon del E square by del T minus sigma E square. Okay, this is the net total power flow. This is total power flow. I can use your red pen for this. And this is the first one. Rate of decrease in magnetic field and the second one, I will use another pen. The second one is rate of decrease in electric field. What does it mean? Now I will say, this is the total power flow. Say it is 100 watt. For our power flow, that in electromagnetic wave, this is the total power flow. And we know what is divergence? To spread from a point. That means it is going through any area. So that is del dot P. That means total power flow is equal to, why there is a minus? Because power is decreasing. And I have told you, if there is any decreasing or reducing manner, we have to use minus. There is minus. That means it is decreasing. If we have supplied here 100 watt, for example, it will decrease to zero to the right side. That means, the first one, del H by del H square by del T. That means this is the decrease in, or this is the decrease power in magnetic field. Del H means magnetic field power decrease, and del E, this is the electric field power decreased. First one, magnetic field decreased, and second one is electric field, electric field decreased, and last one, sigma E square. Sigma means conductivity, and E square, if we consider sigma E square, it is the ohmic loss. That means as like as our I square R, simply like this, I square R. So if we supply 100 watt, at first, it will decrease in magnetic field. Say it is 30 watt, for example. And in magnetic field, it is 30 watt, total 60. Now, and the remaining is here 40 watt. That is the total power. That means total power flowing from any point or any area, it will be the summation of rate of decrease in magnetic field and plus rate of decrease in electric field minus ohmic losses. And what the theorem says, pointing theorem states that the net power flowing out of a given volume V, that is any closed surface, is equal to the time rate of decrease in the energy stored. That means decrease in energy in electric field and decrease in energy in magnetic field, both are the summation, within V minus, there is a minus, the conduction losses or ohmic losses. That's the theorem. Now we will compare like this. Del dot P, that is total power flow in a closed volume V, is equal to summation of total energy released. That means mu into del H square by del T. This is the energy decrease in magnetic field plus epsilon into del E square by del T. This is the electric field energy decrease minus ohmic loss, or simply we can write conduction loss. Same term, ohmic loss, or sometimes it is write like this, conduction loss. And this equation, that means what will be the equation number? This will be equation number 5, I think. And equation number 5 is the expression for pointing theorem. Equation five is the equation for yes.
The looper equation.
I cannot hear you properly. Again, repeat.
Sir, in last line, we cannot see.
Okay. I will zoom it. Okay. Equation five is the. And I will give you picture of this case quite well. Equation 5 is the equation for pointing theorem. Okay. That's our pointing theorem. Very, very important for electromagnetic wave. This is the power relation for electromagnetic wave. Now, if there is any question, you are free to ask me. And I will send the picture of this equation or this theorem. Don't worry about this. Any question up to this?
No, sir.
Up to this, there is no, but I have again same work. You have to write it by yourself in your script. Then if you found any problem, then again discuss with me. Sir, we have problem on this part, or I didn't understand this part. You are free to ask me. Okay. At first, you also try as I have tried here. Actually, this equation is done in your book. You can search here or in Google. It is very hard language, and the mathematics is very tough. I have found there. Then today morning, I have tried for myself. To find out this kind of solution, and this can be acceptable, I can guarantee you. If you just understand this, and if you just write this, inshallah, it will be right. There will be no worry. And if someone is interested in book or in internet, you can search it, and you can solve in their way. That can be also acceptable. Both are same, but their language is quite tough, and their mathematics is quite difficult. I found, but you can try. You are free. If there is no query, then I will talk for another part. Also, if there is any query about this. Ibrahim. Okay, now we will talk about our final exam. Do you have any idea about our final exam date?
No, sir.
It will be on next month, 9th or 10th. 9th of August or